Welcome everyone, my name is Christian Geyer and we are going to talk about how to use Table1 CC to help you create your Table1 efficiently. I'll talk you through that tutorial posted under links and we can walk through that together. So when you follow this link, you will get here to this blog post. Simply scroll down until you reach this section. So this tutorial uses a sample data set that was generated by Claudia and Dana. So let's select this and download this. Okay, so I'm using LibreCalc, but you can also use Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets. Okay, so select all columns, right click and select copy. And now you simply go to the Table1 CC website. Scroll to this field where it says Step 0, copy the raw spreadsheet data and paste it into this field. So let's do just that. So you right click and you click paste. And don't worry like what it looks like here. Once it's there, click I pasted the spreadsheet data. And wait a second, and you'll get notified. Table parsed successfully. And now you simply follow the instructions. So step one, select variables of interest and select the variable type. So let's select all the variables. Okay, so let's select the variable type. So age should be a continuous variable, gender, categorical, cholesterol level should be continuous, blood pressure should be continuous, BMI, I believe here is categorical, smoking categorical, education is categorical. Great. Next, you select the grouping variable. So here we set gender, and that's it. So you're done. You hit make table one. Okay, wait a second. And when you scroll down, here we are. So actually, that's a good point of what not to do. So I took BMI as a grouping variable, but it's clearly not categorical. So let's switch that to a continuous variable. Hit make table one again, and boom, we have it updated. That's just an example, but you can use that with any data set that you have. You can also easily edit things. So let's say, for example, gender here, we're already stratifying by gender. So having another variable gender may not be the most helpful. So if you want to get rid of that, simply uncheck gender, click again, make table one, scroll down and boom. If you want to calculate the p-values, hit calculate p-values. And now you have the p-values listed as well as the methods used. That also changes. So let's see, for example, you think that after all, systolic blood pressure isn't continuous. It's actually non-normal distributed. So right now it's using a t-test. So let's see what it does when we refresh that. So now it's using a Kruskal-Wallis test to check. And it's no longer repeating the mean. It's reporting the median and the interquartile range. So it does that quite automatically. In case you're curious how this works, just go back to the Table1 website. We have a blog and you can read about how it works. It's like really your selections, they are translated into a Python code and then it uses the Table1 Python module, which is then sent back. All of that is encrypted, so you can always feel confident. Okay, feel free to use a different data set. We have a few more here on the website. Here is another sample data set from a clinical trial published in the BMJ. So you can use that as well. You can read FAQs. You can look at the source code if you're interested, or follow us on Twitter. So hope you find this interesting and helpful. Post any questions you may have, and take care.